How's it going? Today, there was a requested video, and I am going to go ahead and deliver on it. So the absolutely wonderful, lovely everything he that has basically been here since the beginning of the channel, all the love in the world to you. You were wonderful. I had requested kind of a Q&A, a 20 facts about you. Now, I kind of looked around and found some ASMR videos that are Q&A based, and I kind of compiled what I saw the normal questions were in quite a few of those. So I have 15 questions for myself to read off and give you answers to today. I thoroughly hope that you all enjoy this, and maybe this gives you a little bit of insight on the type of person I am. Although, to be honest, I feel like I've been pretty open up until now. I think this was a really good suggestion, though, just because there are some things that maybe were sprinkled through another video that somebody didn't see, and I completely get that. You know, you're not going to watch my entire backlog of videos if you just subscribed, or if you're finding this in the future, this is something where it's a lot more compartmentalized. So, again, everything, Keith, this was a fantastic suggestion. I said in the comments as well that I left back for you, but genuinely, thank you. You are such a sweetheart. But without further ado, let's get into it. So, the first question is, how old are you? And I'm actually going to, I guess, answer a little bit further on this. So I'm 26. My birthday is the first week of August. And I actually celebrate it with my cats because we know that they were born the first week of August, not the exact day. So we all have our birthday on August 3rd every year, which is really nice being able to share it with both of them. We'll get them like little tiny hats, and then we'll get some tuna or something like that. Get a little cat bed, some new toys, that sort of thing every year, so it's a nice little celebration. So I am 26, I will be 27 next year. This is currently 2020 when I am recording this, barely, but it's still 2020 right now. So 2021, August 2021, I'll be 27. So this one, I would say, is a little bit more complicated. And I have had this question in my mind. What do you say to that? Because I was originally born in Erie, Pennsylvania. And I lived there for 2 years. And then I moved to Detroit, actually, Michigan, when I was 2 years old. I remember very little about Detroit, to be quite honest. I remember it being fun. But obviously, I was only two when we moved there, and I moved to Ohio, where most of my family is from. At age five, I lived in, like, Miamisburg. I lived up in Columbus and Pickerington. We lived pretty close to Dublin at one point. I lived in Cincinnati for quite a while. We lived in, Fairborn, Ohio for quite a while. Kettering, so pretty much all over the state. Yellow Springs. I apologize, Springfield. I visited Yellow Springs all the time because I had a friend there. All over the state of Ohio. And then I also lived in Florida and Mulberry. And essentially, I'm like, what do you say to that question, essentially? Those are all the places that I lived before this point in my life. I don't really want to disclose where I live now, to be quite honest. The only thing I will disclose is that I am in an Eastern time zone. And I am in the northern part of the United States. I do live in the United States. Obviously, I'm not going to have much of an accent because all of the places I just listed off do not have an accent whatsoever. Living in Ohio, the only thing people relate to is like the oop when you accidentally bump into them. Pennsylvania, pretty much the same thing. That and going to, what is it? The gas station. Oh, how am I forgetting the name? I'll insert it in the comments, maybe. But recently. The long and short of it is I got on a new medication. I have a hormone disorder and I have fibromyalgia. And I got medication for the fibromyalgia that caused me to gain quite a bit of weight. So I have picked up, I had already been doing a lot of yoga before this point, and I had been doing a fair amount of just normal workouts, like ab workouts, planking and such beforehand. I gained, I think, 40 pounds with working out on a consistent basis previous. And I do want to just highlight this because genuinely getting on a new medication can be absolutely devastating to your body until your body gets used to it. Thank goodness I am used to it at this point because it's a necessary medication. But I've been really, really big in doing like plyometrics. I've been doing a lot of HIIT. I'm about to start running actually. Just a lot with that. So I would say some kind of working out is also a big hobby. I'm very into cooking and baking as well, so I do that quite a bit. And another thing, I'm actually starting to learn how to, like, I guess it's pretty much anything DIY I've been trying to learn. So like making pretty much my own candles, my own little containers, concrete containers for candles, pretty much anything that I can personally DIY. Another big one that I've been working on as of late is I have a bracelet that I had got that it has real pearls in it, and I'm vegan, so I'm never gonna buy pearls in my life, but I received it as a gift many years ago and I want to reuse it since I already have it. The bracelet is broken, but I've been trying to get jewelry made out of it so I can just wear a necklace that has it on there, probably like three of the pearls, like a gold strand or something like that. So I've been trying to learn how to do that. You have to get like a little drill for it. I've been very into the DIY scene as of late, so that's the biggest hobby, would just be anything that I can do with my hands. And I eventually want to get into woodworking because I feel like I'd be really good at that. I'm a very I'm not an instant gratification person. I like seeing things happen slowly over time, being able to look at the end result after everything and be proud of it. So I'm a very patient person, I'll say it that way. Next one was actually relationship or marital status. I think a couple of people know this because they've seen my hand, and I'll actually explain this too. I'm married. I've been married for a couple of years now. I'm going on 6 years with my spouse. My spouse is non-binary, so that's why I always say spouse in the videos. And this actually is because of the hormone disorder as well. If I have too much salt, I blow up like a balloon. So I just got it tattooed. It was really cheap. I think it was $80 for the initial band part. And then the part under it, I think it was somewhere in the range of like $100. So I only paid, I paid less than $200 for this. And I'm never going to lose it. You know what I mean? I will say, if you were planning on getting hand tattoos, you can actually see the ink a lot of times right there is the biggest one. The ink a lot of times will spread. So if you do get a tattoo on your fingers or your hands, make sure that the design is large enough where if it bleeds, it's not going to look bad. That's why we picked this one, because it's basically, it's a crown. But it works because it's already kind of a little loop-de-loop. It bled a little bit and it wasn't too bad. It doesn't look that bad, to be honest. And everybody can clearly tell what it is when I speak to them in person. So, pro tip, if you're getting a hand tattoo, just make sure it's big. And also be prepared for it. There's an entire spiel that they do every time where they're like, maybe you won't be able to get a job because you have a hand tattoo. I mean, I had a job for many years, but again, like, this is a ring, so it might be a little bit different, but preparing you, heads up. You know, I actually will answer another one too, just related in terms of the amount of tattoos I have. I'm currently at 3. I have another 5 planned that I've already been drawing out. I forgot to even mention that in hobbies. I'm getting into drawing. I'm trying to do kind of like old style medieval shading and everything, where it's the, I cannot remember, it's the shading where you basically do X's pretty much the entire time, because I have an entire rib piece that I'm going to be making myself with my favorite animal, which I won't mention further down this list. Okay, did you go to school? I already answered this without realizing it. I graduated in Florida. I went to high school primarily in Florida. I was in Ohio for my freshman year. Previous to that, I moved all over the state of Ohio going to school there, so I got all of my education from kindergarten all the way up to my sophomore year at the very beginning in Ohio, and I spent the last three in Florida. I will say, curriculum-wise, completely different. Just being honest, I was not the brightest bulb. No, I wouldn't say the brightest bulb. I was having a lot of issues because of my hormone disorder, and I was not considered the smartest person in the room when I lived in Ohio. Florida's curriculum, I was in all AP classes doing the same amount of effort and everything that I had previously been doing. And I think I graduated with a 3.2 after getting straight Fs for an entire semester my first year of high school. We did find out I was sick with my hormone disorder after that, and that's why it helped. I was so sick I didn't want to do anything, but yeah, very weird. Anyway, apologies. Next one I already kind of answered, but do you have pets? Yes, I have two cats. Their names are Jonas and Esco. They are little tiny cats. They're short hairs. I think they are both five this year. Yeah, they're both five currently. We've had them since they were 6 months or so. We got them on Valentine's Day. And I remember we lived on an apartment on a hill, and we had to slide down the hill because it was very snowy out. We slid down the hill with our boots and had to go to a grocery store that was right across the way, so we had a snowball fight outside. When we had to get supplies for the cats, like the litter box and everything. So we found out the day of that we were able to pick them up. We had been planning to get the supplies that weekend, but we went down and got everything for them, and it was just really nice being able to have kind of a little eventful Valentine's Day with our new family, essentially. Right, next one is, what languages do you speak? So I've kind of mentioned this in a video. Obviously, I'm fluent in English, or am I? And in terms of other languages that I speak, I have on and off almost my entire life spoke German. I have some German family members, but they do not live anywhere near me at this point, so I haven't even spoken a word of it except for little ones here and there in years. I'm trying to get back into it with like old notes because I spoke German off and on for years. Went to school my freshman year and part of my sophomore, took German, did well in it, did not use it after that point. So I'm looking at my old notes, and I also have, you know, you have the Rosetta Stone. I have some friends on Twitter that are German. I've been asking them things too. Reading a lot of news articles to pick back up on things, but I would definitely not say I'm comfortable with speaking it consistently. I just have some parts of it that are down, so I would say I probably have like, I can speak like Kinderdeutsch or something like that. I also spoke Spanish quite a bit when I was in Florida, obviously, because you need to, genuinely, if you live in California or Florida. If you live in California or Florida, you definitely need to speak Spanish. I would say Texas too, just because if that large portion of the population, that's the primary language that they speak, you want to be able to communicate with people and meet people and, you know, intermingle. America's a melting pot. It's great. It's wonderful. You can learn Spanish. It's easy. I spoke it pretty well for a couple of years, and I have literally not used it since. So I can read it. I barely speak it at all. I can read a lot of it. That's another one that after I'm done with German, I'm going to be restudying. That comes into play with something later on, actually. But I also attempted to learn French because my mom spoke it to us when we were children. But seriously. And especially with Russian into that mix, it makes literally no sense. French, it makes no sense to me. I can read on paper, but the minute I start pronouncing anything, it doesn't make sense. And the cadence doesn't make any sense to me. I tried learning Japanese, which I will say was incredibly difficult. The only thing I learned how to say was the fruit was expensive, and I forgot it. Now, I play a bunch of games that have Japanese regularly in them, so I will understand phrases when I hear them. But if it's on paper, I have no clue. I can't even understand what kanji is what. But that's one of the ones on my list, and Korean too. Possibly. I know that Chinese is pretty much the hardest just because of the, again, the cadence of how you say things. The pronunciation, you could say the same word, but depending on how you basically round it out, it's something completely different. That is probably something I want to learn in the future, though, because, again, it just, with America being a melting pot, I want to be able to actually communicate with people, which is, again, also why I'm trying to learn these other languages so I can understand what's going on around me. I can possibly help other people understand, and on top of that, I'm actually, it's just an issue with being able to give accessibility to others. So if somebody doesn't know where they are and they don't speak English, maybe I can help them. You know, it's a situation where maybe I could be an assistance. I'm actually learning sign language for that reason as well, because I have dealt with a couple of deaf people in my life, and having to not being able to help as much as I can, not being able to communicate, is just so frustrating, and I feel for them, so I definitely want to learn that as well. I like learning languages, I will definitely say, and since I already spoke a little bit more when I was a kid, it's pretty easy for me. It's just if I don't use it, I absolutely lose it. I will remember like 5 words and be like, oh, I haven't heard that in years. But yeah, on to the next one. That was a bit of a long answer, huh? Oh, hey guys, it's me from the future, but not really like a day, it's like a day. Recording this Q&A video, realize it's extremely long, so you're going to see this outfit twice. I'm just going to do an outro, split it in two, just to make it a little bit more palpable for everybody in terms of their enjoyment, whether or not committing to a 35 to 40 minute video. You know, it's... we want things are maybe a little bit shorter as well, and I will say I talked a lot in this Q&A video, so there's not really much I want to cut out because it's honest answers. I went into depth, and I definitely want to say as well, in the future, I think I would want to do a Q&A where maybe I actually get some questions from the community, my community specifically, not just finding other questions that most other people like. So if that is something you are interested in, please let me know in the comments. I love reading them, and definitely you guys have been fantastic. You give me so many great ideas. Thank you. But as far as this video goes, I hope that you are well, and I hope that you stay well. I hope you